Hi, it's Jamie from jamiewithguitar.com here. I'm giving you a video lesson for Ed Sheeran's The A Team today. A couple of things we need to go through before we start having a look at this one. As with any song that I try and do a lesson for, I try and make sure it's as authentic as it possibly can, so as close to what I think they're playing as I can get it. There's a couple of ways I try and do this. One is to have a look at any videos of them playing it live, that you can kind of see what the hand's doing. That's one way of doing it. Secondly, obviously, is to use my ear and try and pick out what I think they're doing that way. And another way of doing it is to get the official kind of published tab and check that against what I've got and see if it kind of matches up. Now, with this one, I had a look at the kind of official tab for it, and that doesn't marry up too closely with what I've seen Ed Sheeran doing in a video. There's a really useful video for this where he's doing an acoustic version on the barge on the river, and you can see quite clearly the chords that he's making in that video, and it doesn't seem to tie too much up to the tabbed version of it that I checked. So what I'm going to show you today is the ones that I can see him doing in the video, and hopefully that's going to be a little bit more authentic. It's a slightly strange set of chords, but they're kind of, it's your standard kind of G, E, C, D kind of chord, but with a couple of little variations in there and a few slightly different ways of playing those chords. So I'll take you through each of those and we'll have a look at that. So I'm going to switch over to super close-up mode now so you can see exactly the chords that we're going to need for this song. Okay, here we are in super close-up mode. I'm going to take you through the first few chords we need for the intro and verse patterns of this song. First thing you're going to notice, I'm sure, is that I've got my cap on the second fret. Quite a common thing in a lot of Ed Sheeran songs, certainly something we're going to have to do with this one. What it does is kind of effectively brings everything up two frets, so we now kind of take it that the capo here is the nut, if you like. So that's now the open fret, if you like, and these two frets no longer exist. So to give an example of what I mean by that, this first chord pattern we've got here is kind of like a G shape, because we're actually starting it at the fifth fret, because we kind of brought everything up to, that's really an A chord, but we talk about it relative to this as if this was the nut of the guitar, so we call that a G pattern, okay, which also makes it a little bit easier to kind of remember, because you'll be familiar with that pattern, hopefully. So yeah, that's our first chord, it's a G shape. You'll notice it's not the kind of more standard version of G, which would be more like that, first, second and third fingers. What we do instead is what I like to call the stacked version of G. And what we do is we take this third finger and it's going to go down a string. Okay, so it's going to go to the second string there. Little finger, we're going to pop that one on exactly where the third finger has just come from, and then put the other fingers back on, and what we get by doing that is an extra D note. We've already got a D in the chord, it's this open string here, the fourth string, so it's not really changing the makeup of the chord as such, it just gives us a little bit of a different voicing, if you like, so it sounds like this. Okay, so that's our first chord. The second chord we're going to need is kind of like a passing chord, really, which takes us between the G and the E minor, which is going to come in a second. And what we do for that, we leave it pretty much the same. First and second fingers, though, they're going to both come off. First finger is going to go to the second fret. Remember, we're talking as if this was the nut here. Second fret here on the sixth string. Second finger is going to go on the second fret as well, but on the third string, okay, so they're kind of there. And what that gives us, if we had to kind of give a technical name to the chord, I guess it would be a D sus 4 over F sharp, but I shouldn't worry too much about that, really. We're just using it in a capacity that it's quite a nice little way of getting from G to E minor, really. We're not going to worry too much about the technicalities of it. So that's our next chord. And then we get down to the E minor, which we're going to do with first and second fingers this time because they're here. Now I've kind of studied the videos I can find online of Ed Sheeran playing this song live and stuff quite meticulously to see what he does with this third and fourth fingers, because it's quite difficult to pick it out on the album version, because as we're going to see in a second, the strumming pattern is a little bit kind of almost restricted in a way, so we don't really hit the top two strings very often. Now, from one of the videos I saw of him doing, I think he takes the third and fourth fingers off. So that's what we're going to do here. It's not going to make a massive amount of difference, to be quite honest, either way. It's certainly not going to sound out of key if you leave them on, because this is how it would sound. That's with them on and off. It's
not a huge amount of difference, so don't worry too much about it. But if we're going to try and be super authentic, I guess that's what we need to do. Okay, and then that's our next chord, third chord in the little sequence we've got so far. And then the last chord for this little bit is going to be a C chord, but it's a slight variant of C. So we're going to stick that third and fourth back on where we were. We're going to put our first and second fingers down here. Actually on the fifth and fourth strings this time. It's like the G pattern, the first one we had, but you just move your first and second both up a string, one string towards the floor. That's what we get. It's technically a C add 9, because again we've got that added D note in there, which isn't normally in a C triad. Okay, so that's our last chord of that little section. I'm going to switch the camera over now to have a look at my right hand so you can see what the strumming pattern kind of looks with that. But I'm going to play through these chords once just so you can see it closer to my left hand, what it kind of looks like. So here we go. Okay, here we are. I'm going to show you the very basic kind of strumming pattern for the right hand. As I said a second ago, it's a little bit kind of restricted, and what I mean by that is we're not really going to be hitting all the strings all of the time. It's, for the most part, palm muted, so you're going to take this very kind of fleshy part of your palm here, and you're going to stick it just very slightly to the left of where the strings make contact with your bridge, with the white saddle part here. Okay, so about here. Gives you that muted sound, but hopefully you're already familiar with palm mutes. And what we're going to do, I'm holding the very first chord from the intro, by the way, that first G chord. And what we're going to do is this kind of little, big, little, big, little, big pattern. All right, so your first hit is going to be just like that. So kind of sixth and fifth strings. But I mean, I guess I would say that a lot of this song, something to remember is don't be too meticulous with it. So if you hit the sixth and fifth, that's great. If you kind of go a little bit too far and hit the fourth, who cares? Don't worry about it, it's fine. So that's going to be our first one. And then that's what I'm calling little. Now the big is going to be going about to the fourth string. Again, don't be too meticulous. If it does go to the second, don't worry about it too much. So it's going to be like this. Little, big, little, big, little, big, little, big, little, big. There we go. Now, I mentioned earlier when we were looking at the left-hand chords that we kind of think of the right hand as a little bit restricted. You don't really hit the top two strings very much. What I'm going by that is the album version of the song, just the acoustic guitar, which kind of does the chord shapes all the way through the song. It doesn't hit those top two strings very often. It mainly sticks with that palm muted approach on the kind of the thickest bottom four strings, really. However, one of the best things about Ed Sheeran as an artist, if you watch any of his kind of videos on YouTube of him playing it live, or if you're lucky enough to go and actually see him play it live, he likes to mix up his approach quite a lot, and kind of takes a bit of a fresh approach to it each time he plays it, which I think sounds really good. So what you'll see him do quite often if you watch him play that live is he'll kind of stick to that same basic pattern, but every now and again he'll kind of break out of the palm mutes, he'll hit some of the top strings, he'll put up strokes as well as downs in, all of these kind of things to make it sound a little bit different. So a lot of the live ones kind of sound a bit more like this. As I said just a second ago, we're mixing in, rather than just doing that kind of straightforward little big downward strokes with a palm mute, I'm coming out of doing a palm mute, it's just hitting the strings without the palm mute in there, hitting the top strings as well, and chucking some up strokes in there, and just mixing up a little bit. So those are the kind of three key things to be looking at if you want to try and kind of emulate a little bit more how he does things live, rather than the more straightforward album version of the song. Okay, we're back looking at the left hand now, because I'm going to show you the next few chords we're going to need for the pre-chorus and the chorus sections. Luckily they don't get too much more difficult, and mostly they're kind of recycled from the intro and the verse, so it's only a couple of different chords really that we're going to have to add in. The pre-chorus section is going to start off with an A minor 7, okay, which looks a little bit like that. kind of like an A minor with a hole in it, okay? So make a normal A minor and take third finger off. Easy as that. So that's what we're left with, okay? Just the first and second fingers on there. Played from the fifth string open, as mostly A chords are. And that's what it's going to sound like. Really cool, laid-back sounding chord. That's your first one of the pre-chorus. Then it's going to go to a C chord. Very, very straightforward C chord this time, rather than C add 9 or whatever. And it's kind of the easiest chord change in the world, because all we're going to do is put your third finger on there, on that C note, on the fifth string. That's it. That's the next chord. Then we're going to go back to the G. Again, the stacked version with the third and fourth fingers there. And then to finish off that pre-chorus section, goes to the passing chord, okay? So that kind of D sus 4 over F sharp type job. There we go. And that's the pre-chorus chords, so I'll play that through. When you play this one with your right hand, kind of break a little bit more out of the palm mutes with this one, and also you're going to be hitting the top two strings a little bit more. So it's going to sound something like this. So that's the pre-chorus. Next comes the chorus, which is probably actually the easiest part of the song so far, I would say. Starts off with an E minor, completely standard version of a chord, so I'm choosing to do it with second and third fingers. And that's what we've got right there. Then it goes up to another standard C major chord. And then we finish back with, again, a stacked version of the G, and that's kind of it for the chorus section. As I said, it's probably a bit more straightforward than the other bits, so I'm going to play that one for you. Etc, etc. And then to get back into the verse pattern, all that happens is on the very last time you play the G, you go to the passing chord and then come back to G. And that's kind of it, just that little kind of turnaround. So and then you're back into the verse pattern.
Okay, there we have the chords and the strumming pattern for A team. Hope that helps. One thing we didn't really go into with that was how many kind of bars you play each chord and how many times you play each chord for. I don't think in a song like this that does you any favours to kind of have that at the front of your mind. Use your ear to tell you how long each of the chords last for, as long as you can, and do it that way, and it will just sound a little bit more organic, and it will probably be a little bit more enjoyable to play if you do that. It's not too complicated how long each of them lasts, so I don't think you really need to be thinking about it too meticulously. Other things to watch out for, or to bear in mind right while you're playing it, is to not be too strict about it. I mean, I've shown you the strum pattern, as you can hear on the album version, and how the chords are played as closely as I can see from the videos that Ed puts out on YouTube. But as I said briefly when we were looking at the strum pattern, one of the best things about when Ed Sheeran plays live, as I can attest to, because I was lucky enough to catch him live a little while back, is that he always mixes it up and does things a little bit differently each time, and it gives that really kind of fresh and dynamic sound to his song. So try and do that a little bit in your playing as well. So a couple of methods I talked about with that is break out the palm mutes every now and again, chuck a few upstrokes as well as downs in there, hit a couple of the top strings rather than just the bottom strings in the verse pattern. Those kind of things are going to help make it sound a little bit better. Hope that helps.